talk to him and mess with stones on him.
I shall try to tell you what I know. The emotions make it difficult to communicate. The creature that has done this is called the Savant. A being of great power that has transformed itself into a creature of living emotion. It can form a link with any creature with psionic abilities, including Vulcans. It taps into latent emotions and amplifies them, using them to increase its emotional stability.
What happens if it gets cut off from you on the Vurian?
It would be alone, but could cope. We enhance its enjoyment, but we are not essential to its survival. We are like a backup system. It relies on us for emotional support, but it could exist without us.
It just doesn't want to.
Captain, I recommend you negotiate with Savant to escape this place. I am expendable.
Expendable? Spock, I see that these emotions have given you a sense of humor.
Sorry, guys. Coughing a lot. Yeah, expendable? Absolutely not.
If we can find a weakness, we might be able to take you with us. What can you tell us, Spock?
Good one.
Spock, can you negotiate with the Savant on our behalf? Spock, we found some very strange stones. What are they? Expendable? Spock, we found some very strange stones. What are they?
This entire pocket dimension is organic and psionic. In order to maintain the Savant's life force, negative emotions that are suppressed might be absorbed in mineral-like pockets beneath the surface of this dimension.
Huh. Interesting. So if we throw the negative emotions back, it dies. It can survive without Spock and the Vurian, apparently. But, countering it with negative emotions would kill it. And thus destroy this entire dimension. I guess it created this dimension?
Captain.
Expendable? If we can find a weakness.
Expendable. I like this one.
As usual, your illogic is beyond comprehension, Captain. If I were human, I might find it delightful.
He's laughing! That's so funny.
Captain.
Expendable? If we can find... Spock, can you negotiate? If we can find a weakness, we might be able to take you with us. What can you tell us, Spock?
Its reliance on emotion is its main weakness. It is a creature of intense needs. And despite having millions of years of joy, it still retains a subconscious fear of losing its joy, of experiencing negative emotions.
It's like somebody's tickling him while he's saying all this stuff.
Captain.
Expendable? If we can find... Spock, can you negotiate with the Savant on our behalf?
It refuses to deal with issues of logic and free will. It is not a violent creature, but is extremely fixated on its goals and believes what it does is morally justified.
Alright, now that we've said all that, let's just save again, because what I'm gonna try now...
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Might cost us points, but I just have to try it. Make Spock feel emotions.
Interesting. The Savant's emotional emanation overpowers this stone's effect.
This is a bad thing to be doing to Spock, so I'm not going to save my results here. Just to see what happens.
Interesting.
Oh, same there.
Interesting.
Interesting. I'm going to try them all.
Interesting. Interesting.
Okay, a whole bunch of stones.
Captain, I strongly recommend against that action. Captain.
Huh. Try to use the medical kit on Spock?
I understand, Mr. Chekhov. It is quite logical.
Huh. Okay.
Mr. Spock.
Captain, Mr. Spock is unconscious. No unusual brain activities. Nothing that you would not expect from an unconscious Vulcan.
Okay, what if now we use these stones?
Interesting.
I thought he was unconscious. Oh, he's awake. Okay, let's restore. Yeah. Load this one. Should we knock him out? Wait. So this is right before we started using those stones. So let's be nice to him. He's extremely uncomfortable over there.
I understand, Mr. Chekhov.
Alright, let's go this way. Oh, can we? We can't go anywhere else. This is the end of everything. I don't know why it plays this music. Technically, we're not in any danger.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
I'm saving here because I'm not sure what we're supposed to tell it.
Welcome.
Not without Spock.
Captain, why do you begrudge your comrade's newfound happiness?
Because it was not his doing, nor his choice.
Right, good one.
Because he's being used by you and held against his will. He has duties and obligations, and you're keeping him from them. Because it was not his doing, nor his choice.
Right.
There are many things in nature that are not desired, but bring good fortune. Be content with your comrade's serendipity, and ask for your safe return to your vessel.
Never.
Welcome.
Not without Spock.
Captain, why do you begrudge?
Because it was not his doing, nor his. Because he's being used by you and held against his will.
I give far more than I receive, Captain. If you truly love your comrade, you will not deny him bliss.
Okay. So we're actually almost done with this dialogue tree then.
Welcome.
Not without Spock.
Not without Spock dialogue
Captain,
tree.
Why do you begrudge?
Because it was not his doing. He has duties and obligations, and you're keeping him from them.
Don't think this will work either.
Even over the course of a short period of time, Captain, duties and obligations have little meaning.
Okay. Not the right line of questioning to...
Welcome. Have you come?
Not without Spock. Savant, isn't there anything I can do to make you see reason? Release Spock, or we will be forced to destroy you. Not without Spock. Release Spock, or we will be forced to destroy you.
Try this without luck.
Captain, your capabilities are infinitesimal compared to mine. My joy is diminished that you feel it necessary to make this threat. But I do not see how you can bring it to fruition.
You underestimate our will and resourcefulness. In the end, you will be forced to release Spock, or be destroyed, or destroy us.
Hmm.
We don't want to threaten you. Release Spock and return us to our ship. Put an end to this now. You are single-minded and inflexible, Savant. You have great power, but also great weaknesses, which we will use against you if you do not return our comrade to us.
These are all good, all threatening.
You underestimate our will and resolve.
I will not abandon a course of action that I feel is correct. I will not abandon others to suffering when they can experience joy. Welcome.
Not without Spock. Savant, release Spock.
Captain.
You underestimate our... We don't want to threaten you. Release Spock and return us to our ship.
How easily you celebrate endings, Captain. I will not end this. It is in my power to bring bliss for eternity. And I shall not cease. Mortality and endings have no meaning to me.
I guess people don't age in this dimension?
Welcome.
Not without Spock. Release Spock or we will...
Captain,
You underestimate. We don't want to threaten you. Release Spock. You are single-minded. You are single-minded and inflexible, Savant.
I do not understand your attitude, Captain. Your threats are meaningless. When you are ready to leave, you may ask me, and I shall return you to your craft.
Notice there is no actual way to ask him to return us to the ship.
Save new game.
Oh, nope. I want to load. Well, I think threatening it might cost us points. Oh, this would cost us points as well.
Captain, may I suggest we rescue Commander Spock first and then take samples?
We may not have time, Lieutenant.
But it feels like minerals to me.
Even so,
rescuing
Spock is our highest priority. Let's get moving.
That's funny.
No problems with this phaser.
This will cost us points for sure. It's not going to do anything. We're going to stand all the way over there? Okay.
Violence is useless, Captain.
Sorry, would you prefer stun then?
Violence is useless.
Then I shall heal you.
Captain, the Savant is not life as we know it. My medkit is useless against him.
Alright, okay, let's load again. Okay,
Welcome.
Not without Spock. Savant, isn't there anything I can do to make you see reason?
Okay, the other dialogue trees are obviously dead ends. This middle one, though, I think there's three.
Captain, I do see reason. My intellect is many orders of magnitude beyond yours. You should trust my judgment.
I trust Spock's judgment, and you're imprisoning his free will.
Mm-hmm.
Savant, creatures like ourselves need to be free to make mistakes and to learn from them.
I think I chose this
Only
one
then
before.
Can, really? I see you have great power and great... I trust... Really? I see you have great power and great splendor, but I don't see great wisdom.
I have taken sorrow and turned it into bliss. I have taken that which denied feelings and have shown him his true nature. Is that not wisdom? Welcome.
Not without Spock. Savant is released. Not with Savant is not without Spock.
Here there is strength.
Savant isn't...
Captain. I do see reason.
I trust Spock's judgment, and you're imprisoning his free will.
Did we choose that one before?
Savant, creatures like ours, really? I trust Spock's judgment, and you're imprisoning his free will.
Free will is an arrogant deception, Captain. When one looks at the universe in a broad perspective, one finds that fate is far less flexible than it may appear. Welcome.
Not without Spock. Savant, isn't there any...
Captain, I do see reason.
I trust Spock's... Savant, creatures like ourselves need to be free to make mistakes and to...
But I can elevate him to my level without any suffering. He need not experience the hardships that my race experienced. Is this not an extreme act of mercy?
Okay, well that's it then. We'll destroy the universe if we throw the bag of stones there. I don't think it's a good answer, but...
That is an odd sensation, Lord.
Alright, the bag of stones.
No, Grieve! Pain! Gentle lords, why have you inflicted this upon me? I thought I was free of grief forever.
I'm sorry, we need to attract the attention of the Savant.
Okay, so if I'm correct now, Spock is unconscious, so he's not providing any, you know, happiness feedback to the Savant, and now this thing is feeling grief and pain, so it's not as well.
I'm sorry, I wasn't sure of what would happen. I'm sorry, we need to attract the attention of the Savant.
It was not necessary. He awaits you at the fountainhead. Leave me in peace.
I wouldn't listen.
Greetings, Lord Kirk. I suspect you have come to render me as unconscious as your comrade. It is no longer in my power to resist.
Are you willing to help me, Emanata?
Number V766, are you frightened of us?
Are you willing to help me, Emanata?
Are you frightened of us?
I am so full of joy, Lord Kirk, that it is difficult for me to experience other emotions. Even ones I know I should be feeling, such as regret. Do to me what must be done.
So I guess we use the med kit to render it unconscious as well?
Greetings, Lord Kirk.
Are you willing to help me, Emanata?
Through the Savant, I know your desires. Why should I help release the poor Vulcan into a life of misery?
Because I need him to save the lives of over 400 people on the ship.
Right.
Because Spock does not want artificial joy. He does not want this lie.
Also true.
Because I need him to save the lives. Because Spock does not want artificial joy.
Very well, Captain. I will help you.
Alright, going to reload. Because I think giving it those stones... We inflicted pain, emotional pain on it, so we might lose points that way. Try not to have a horrible ending to this. Will they send us back to Starfleet Academy or something to, you know, have us replaced temporarily or worse? So let's just talk to it then.
Greetings, Lord Kirk.
Are you willing to help me, Emanata?
Through the Savant, I know your desires.
Because I need him to save the lives of over 400 people on the ship.
Very well, Captain. I will help you.
Okay, they're both good choices. Let's just scan it. Or her, rather.
No effect, Captain. I don't have enough knowledge of Vorian anatomy. Captain, its anatomy is completely alien. I'm afraid the medical kit will not do much good.
So then we make it unconscious with the stones? Or should we stun it? Which is worse? Tell you the truth, I don't even know. Well, that worked, I guess.
The Vurian is still, and perhaps surprisingly, at peace.
At peace? It's not dead, is it?
No effect, Captain. I don't have any...
It's not dead, right? We can't even tell if it's dead? I used the stun. Okay, now let's try talking to it.
Not without Spock. Savant, isn't there anything I can release? Not without Spock. Release Spock or we will... Savant, isn't...
Captain, I do see...
I trust Spock. Savant, creatures like ourselves need... Really? I trust... Really? I... Savant, creatures like our...
But I can elevate him to my level without any suffering. He need not experience the heart.
Alright, well... Try these again? Now that these two are unconscious, maybe these stones will have greater effect?
This object has no effect against me.
They're a little big, Captain.
Captain, the Savant is not life as we know it. My medkit is useless against me.
Hmm.
Welcome.
Not without Spock.
Captain.
Because it was not his doing, nor his choice.
There are many things in nature.
Wow. Really unsure as what to do here. Let us try something. Okay, I know when I threw the gems, there was some conversation options after that, I believe. So let's try that again.
You disturb my rest. Fortunately, I am not alone in bliss. Do not use such a tactic again on me. I warn you. What is this? What am I feeling? What have you done?
What's the matter, Savan? Not feeling those good vibrations? Life isn't all happiness and joy. It's time you experienced a reality check.
Is that the one we chose?
Is that sadness you're feeling, Savan? It couldn't be that those inferior humans have outwitted your great wisdom, could it? What's the matter, Savan? Is that sadness you're feeling, Savan?
All I sought was the best for them. Why are you tormenting me?
You're holding me up.
Force you to respect other people. Free Spock, and return us to our ship, and the torment will end.
We chose that one.
The best? You're a selfish, self-centered nothing. Eternal bliss? You're an emotional leech that has to use others to give you joy because you're too emotionally stunted to stand on your own 2 feet.
Huh. What feet?
To get you to listen. To force you to respect other people.
Right, this one.
I do more than respect them, Captain. I love them. I only wish you had the psionic abilities necessary to make you feel as I do, as they do. Then you might understand.
Spock feels as you do, and you know that your kind of joy is against his nature. Respect his feelings. Release him.
He has been indoctrinated against joy.
Do it now!
In a short time, that indoctrination will collapse, and he will experience the happiness he deserves.
My God.
Let him make that decision himself.
Very well. You and your comrades will be returned to your ship, and I will have my joy again.
What about the alien?
Captain's log, we are out of the Antares Rift and are on our way to Starbase 8, where the Enterprise has extensive repairs scheduled. All crew members, including First Officer Spock, are safely aboard.
Shields are still up.
You mean you had an eternity of pure enjoyment and you gave it up?
Affirmative, Doctor.
That has to be the most illogical thing I've ever heard. Humans spend their entire lifetime dreaming of an eternity of pleasure.
As do animals in the field. Perhaps humans are meant to be better than that. Perhaps we should dream of greatness, not simple gratification.
Greatness is a term subject to individual interpretation, Captain.
True.
The savant viewed the pursuit of greatness as useless, because all great deeds and accomplishments are destined to be forgotten in cosmic terms.
A cosmic being thinks in cosmic terms, Spock. But somehow that philosophy overlooks a lot of life's little pleasures.
That's a happy song.
There's one thing that bothers me about the whole thing.
Really, Doctor?
Spock finally got to enjoy himself, and I wasn't there to see it.
Comedic song?
Something worth remembering.
Message from Starfleet Command.
That'll be good.
I have reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments.
Oh?
Well done, Kirk. Keep up the good work.
Oh.
I must say, however, your performance is not what we've come to expect from James T. Kirk. I guess we all have our off days, Captain. Kane out.
Whatever. Okay, preview for next episode. Museum piece.
How long until we reach Nova Atar, Ensign?
Nova Atar.
23 hours, Captain.
22 hours, 53 minutes, and 17 seconds, to be precise.
Spock, there's no need to be precise. We're going on shortly. Rest, relaxation, no calls from Starfleet.
Until now.
Captain, we have a message coming in from Admiral Richards at Starfleet.
She sounds...
On screen, Lieutenant.
Hello, Jim.
She sounds happy.
I know you're going on shortly, but...
What is it, Chris?
Well, since you're going there anyway, and it's only a small favor...
Favor?
Yes.
I don't want to inconvenience you, but...
Fine, you have it. What would you like me to do?
But...
I recently discovered that one of the exhibits in the Smithsonian Annex at Nova Atar is of great historical significance to the Saranzi, an influential family from planet Lockean. The museum is going to have a small ceremony to return the item. The Federation planned to send a representative, but, well, she couldn't make it. Since you'll be in the neighborhood, well, no dress uniforms. All you have to do is smile and shake hands.
Smile, shake hands. It would be my pleasure, Admiral. My chief engineer had already promised to show me around. We'll be there.
Thanks, Jim. I owe you one. Check your data files for details. Oh, one more thing, Jim. Due to the security concerns, you won't be allowed to bring any electronic equipment with you.
What?
Richard's out.
Now, I was saying...
Do we really have to stand around and listen to speeches from a bunch of politicians?
It won't be all bad, Scotty. The curator's a major cognac producer, and he asked us to show up early to thank us for our support.
Captain, it'd be rude to keep a man like the curator waiting, what with an important diplomatic function to prepare for.
Okay, guys, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, and endure, and live long and prosper.